Hi, my name is Jason K. I'm a full-stack developer working in South Korea. Today in this video, I'm going to talk about a CSS property called Position. Before we start working on some actual project, it'd be good for us to go through some CSS properties. Developers all have their own preferences when applying styles, but I think it'd be best for us to know what's out there before choosing our own preferences. Today I'm going to talk about a property called Position, which is used to set a layout for your web page. This position property determines how your HTML elements are positioned or located on your web page. There are five different position properties: static, relative, absolute, fixed, and sticky. And there are also properties called top, right, bottom, and left that are used to determine the final location of your positioned elements. Let me show you some examples. First one is static. Static is the default property. So if you don't set anything explicitly, everything is static. When you apply top, right, bottom, or left properties to the static elements, nothing changes. Let's take a look. You see that it pretty much just stays there. The next one is relative. When you apply top, right, bottom, or left properties to relatively positioned elements, it's moving away relative to its normal position. So it's going to move away from its original location. You see how it's moving away from its original position. The third one is the absolute. I hid these two elements to help you understand the absolute property better. Absolute position changes relative to its nearest parent position element. Then what is this parent element? Parent element is what wraps around other elements. Here, div element has class absolute is wrapped around by the section element. This one is the nearest parent. Absolute elements are positioned relative to its nearest parent element. So let me add some styles to it. You see how this thing moves up here? This is because the nearest parent element is a container that is red bordered here. The next one is fixed. So like the name says, it just stays there. This fixed element just stays there. It does not go anywhere. And the last one is sticky. This one is kind of tricky. It's somewhat between relative and fixed. Until the certain position is met, this one's moving like a relative. But when the scroll position is met, it's gonna stay there like a fixed object. If you look at this one, moving away and just stay there. These are the five position properties, and you as a front-end developer gotta choose which one works the best to meet your needs. In the next video, I'm gonna talk about display property called flex and grid, which are very important like I talked about in the last video. So make sure you watch those as well. And just as always, if you wanna learn something specific, please leave them in the comments below so I can answer your questions. Thank you and stay tuned.